morning children. How are you all? I hope all you are fine. This is the critical situation. That's why you have to take care of yourself. Myself, my name is Arunu Kumari Perala from KGBV Naswapeta, Guntur district. Children, this is the good opportunity to learn so many things and so many lessons from your home only. That's why you have to utilize this situation, utilize the lessons and improve your knowledge. Today I am going to tell you about the topic acid, base and salts. Already in the 7th class you learn about the acid, base and salt. You know the what is acid and what is base and what is salt. So you know what is acid. Acid is a salt to taste and it turns blue litmus to red. And base is base, also you know the also base. Soap it to touch and turns blue litmus, red litmus to blue. And also you know the salts. In the 7th class you do the activities with the help of the items provided in your kitchen. Yes, you are doing the very play method, you are doing the activity, you are very happily with that activity. So in the previous class you use this knowledge. Today also we do one activity. We take some acids and some base. With the help of these acids and base, with the help of the indicators we can do one activity. First of all, I am taking the acid, hydrochloric acid. Children, you take care of the acid. While we are doing the activity, you have to take care of yourself. First, I am taking the hydrochloric acid and pour some hydrochloric acid in the wash glass. And I am taking the blue litmus. See, the blue litmus turned to which color, ma? This is turned to red litmus. Yes, red color. Red color. The blue litmus turned to red color. So first sample, I am taking hydrochloric acid HCl. With the help of the blue litmus, these are the indicators. Blue litmus, red litmus are the indicators to find the given substance is acid or base. These are the indicators to find out the which is the acid and which is the base. So red litmus, and I am taking the next. I am taking red litmus. See, there is no change. Next thing, I am taking methyl orange. Methyl orange turn to red color. Yes, see the red color. Methyl orange turn to red color in the acid. And now I am taking the phenolphthalein solution in this. Phenolphthalein solution add with the some hydrochloric acid HCl. What do you see? There is no color. Colorless substance is formed. Same, I am taking hydrochloric acid. With the help of the indicators, I am taking blue litmus, red litmus, methyl orange and phenolphthalein indicators. These are the methyl orange and phenolphthalein indicators. These are also indicators. These four are the indicators to find the given substance is acid or base. With the help of these four indicators, I am doing the practice with the hydrochloric acid. In the same way, the sulfuric acid, same way. This is also acid. So in the acid, the blue litmus turn to red. Red litmus no change. Methyl orange turn to red. And phenolphthalein colorless. The same way, nitric acid. I am taking HNO3. The same way, red. No change. This is red. And colorless. Now I am taking base. hydroxide. What is that? Sodium hydroxide. I am taking sodium hydroxide. With the sodium hydroxide. Sodium, I am making the sodium hydroxide solution. So with the help of the first we will check blue litmus. So there is no change in the blue litmus. See, there is no change in the blue litmus. See difference between the blue litmus turned to red in the HCl. There is no change in the blue. This blue. So no change. No change. No. I am taking the red litmus. See the red litmus turn to blue color. See all of you, blue. So the red litmus turn to blue. See. So blue and methyl orange. I am taking the methyl orange. This is the solution of sodium hydroxide. I pour some methyl orange. See ma, what color you got? You got yellow color. Yes. What you got? You got yellow color. Yes. See. This is yellow color. And now phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein. See, nice. See all of you, which color you got? Very nice. The pink color you got. What color you got? Nice pink color. Okay. So pink. In the same way, we take and this potassium hydroxide. Say it, no change, and it turns to blue litmus, and it turns methyl orange to yellow, and phenolphthalein pink. All of you see the colors? Red, colorless, yellow, and pink. Okay, so in this chapter, first we are doing this activity to with the help of the indicators. What is the acid and what is the which color changed by the acid and which color changed by the base with the indicators. Okay, now we can learn about some properties of acid. Already in the 8th class you learn about the lesson metals and non-metals lesson. The metals react with the acids. What is formed? What is produced? And the metal is react with the acid. You know that. Once again, we can learn about that. We can learn about that activity. Metals, acids, reacts. Already in the 8th class you learn about the metals react with acids. Now this in this chapter we learn about the acids react. react with the metals. Children, in your you have any problem in your stomach, or any your family members suffering with the problem, stomach problem, what do you suggestion to them? You don't know which is the better remedy, lemon juice or vinegar or anything else you don't know about that. If you listen this lesson, you have a clarify about the which is the better remedy to reduce our stomach problem. Okay, so listen carefully. That's why I'm telling to you, listen carefully. Already one activity is completed, that is acids and bases. With the help of the indicators, we can find out the which color produces by the acid and which color produced by the base. Now we are some properties of the acids. Acids react with the metals. So I'm taking zinc granules. Zinc granules in a test tube. I'm taking zinc granules in a test tube. I keep this test tube in the stand. And pour some hydrochloric acid to the zinc granules. What I am doing here, I am taking a test tube and take some zinc granules, and with the zinc granules I am pour some hydrochloric acid. These are the zinc granules and these are the hydrochloric acid. I am keeping on delivery tube in the soap water. This is the soap water. After some time, the zinc granules or zinc granules react with acids. We are mixing zinc granules with acids. Here these two react each other and produce some gas. The gas come to this delivery tube and go to the soap water. And some bubbles are produced in the soap water. Why? Because the bubbles are produced here. Why means? Here some gas is produced by this reaction of the zinc and hydrochloric acid. The zinc and hydrochloric acid react each other and one gas is produced. That gas comes to the soap water and some bubbles are came out. Which gas is produced here? You know? Now, we will see that which gas is produced there. What I am taking here for the chemical reaction, I am taking zinc granules and I am taking hydrochloric acid and zinc granules. These both are react. Zinc granules and hydrochloric acid both are react. And they react. What is formed here? Zinc chloride and what is formed? Zinc chloride and H2 gas. What is here formed? Which gas is liberated here? Which gas is liberated here? Hydrogen gas liberated here. Which gas, ma? Hydrogen. You know the equations in the chemical equations? The gas, you can indicate like this. That means this is the produced one is gas. After the reaction, the produced one is gas. So, here the acid react with the metal. Which gas produced? Hydrogen gas produced. How to test the given now the liberated gas is hydrogen. If you take the gas with the help of any test tube or any beaker, you keep one lightning stick, the sound produces top sound. Then you can find out the liberated gas is hydrogen gas. Now see once again, I am taking hydrochloric acid and zinc granules. I am mixing with these two. And these two are react with each other and produce hydrogen. That means if the acids are react with the metals, hydrogen gas produces. Which gas? Hydrogen gas produces. In the same way, base also. Base react with, here I am taking acid. The same way, acid reacts with the hydrogen gas produces, and same way base. I am taking here base. Here this is acid, this is base. react with metal. Here acid react with metal. Here base is react with the metal. Also, which gas produces hydrogen gas? Produces. If the acid reacts with metals, produces hydrogen gas, and base reacts with metals, produces hydrogen gas. So these are the reaction of acids and base with the metals. Already learned about the acids react with the metals and non-metals. Metals. Acids already we learn about the acids react with metals and base react with metals. Now we are learn about the acids react with carbonates. For that one we are doing one activity. I am taking the test tube. I am taking 0.5 grams of sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate. With the help of the thistle garata, I am pour HCl solution in the hydrochloric acid. In the sodium carbonate, I am pour some 2 grams of dilute HCl acid with the help of the thistle garata. So after close this test tube and after some time the sodium carbonate and acid both are react each other. This sodium carbonate and acid both are react each other and some gas is liberated. The delivery tube. Solution of calcium hydroxide. The calcium hydroxide solution turns into pure white. Pure white. That means here the acid reacts with the sodium carbonate. The acid reacts with sodium carbonate. The some gas is liberated. The liberated gas is called the calcium hydroxide. The liberated gas turns this calcium hydroxide into white precipitate. That means the liberated gas is carbon dioxide. The help of this activity, we can find if the calcium hydroxide turns to white precipitate, the liberated gas is carbon dioxide. So, what we are doing this activity, I am taking hydrochloric acid and sodium carbonate. These two are react with each other. In the previous example, we see if the acid is react with the metals, hydrogen gas react. Hydrogen gas liberated, and the base same way. If the base is react with the metals, hydrogen gas liberated. Here, acids are react with the carbonates, which gas is liberated, carbon dioxide liberated. So, from this two activity, what we learn? If the acids are react with the acids are bases are react with metals, hydrogen gas is produces liberated. If the acids are base are react with the carbonates, carbon dioxide gas is red. These are the chemical properties of the Now, already 7th class, we learn about the neutralization reaction. Once again, we learn about that. First of all, we at the help of the indicators, we check the whether the which is the acid and which is the base, and how the colors changes in the acid and base. And the second one is, we are doing two activities, that is acids react, acids and base react with metals, and acids react with carbonates. And the next one is, if the acid, from these two activities we learn these are the acids react with metals, and these are the acid react with carbonates. Write down this formulas, ma. Acid react with metals and base react with metals. Here sodium carbonate and sodium bicarbonate, these two are the carbonates react with acids, gives carbon acid gas. Write down the formula, that's why I am writing again here. Write down the formula, all of you. These two are the acids react with metals. These two are the acids react with carbonates. All of you write down that. Now, you take 2 grams of, we can do the other activity. Now, in here, we are doing the 2 activities, properties of, chemical properties of acids and base. Now, 2 grams of dilute liquid HCl, which is here, and also sodium hydroxide, that means base. Take 2 grams of HCl and 2 grams of base. Acid. Base. If these two are react, what happen? Acid and base react together, produce salt and water. Isn't it? If the acid react with base, produce salt and water. Acid, HCl, base, sodium hydroxide. These two are react each other. Acid react with base. These two are react with each other. Produce salt, sodium chloride, and water. What is their form? This is salt. What acid react with the base together form salt. This is called the neutralization reaction. What is the reaction name? Neutralization. If the acid react with base, forms salt and water. Acid react with base, produce salt and water. This reaction is called neutralization reaction. So, in the neutralization reaction, if the more acid is there, we can add with the base, we can neutralize the solution. If the base is more, if you add acid, you can learn the previous, after some chapter completed, you can learn about this neutralization also. The neutralization, what is the pH, you can learn about that. So, are you understanding? Neutralization means, if the acid react with base, gives salt and water. That reaction is called the neutralization reaction. Now, take some glucose like that solutions. Electricity content in the water or not, we can check that, we can do that activity also. And take this one. See, here are you. Acid solution conduct electricity. That electricity pass are doing this activity. I am taking glass beaker. In the glass beaker, today 2 graphite rods is there. I am taking acid, dilute sulfuric HCl. Dilute HCl is there. And acid like 230 volts and unbulk. What happen here? In this activity, what do you see here? You can see here. This is the acid solution. In the acid solution, the bulb glows. That means acid solution conduct electricity. Yes. Already in the 8th class we learn about the acids that conduct electricity. Electricity like in the lesson of electricity we learn acids conduct electricity. If at that way acids are conduct. Today we learn about the properties of the acids and bases, and also the acids react with metals and non-metals, and acids react with carbonates and bicarbonates, and acid conduct electricity or not. Okay, so little ma, we have to read the textbook for all these one, and I am giving the small work for this one. Write the. Write the activity when metals react with acids and write an activity carbonates are reacts with acids. Write all this. First of all, you read the textbook. After reading the textbook, you can write the answers for these questions. You learn these activities. Okay ma? After next period, I will explain the what is the pH and what is the range of the pH in our stomach or in our surrounding atmosphere. Like that, I will explain in the next session. So, first of all, you completely learn this one. All these carbonates and reaction carbonates and metals, and also the properties of the acids and bases. One thing, you already learn in the first 2 activity, acids, to find out the given substance is acid or base or which is, for that one you use the indicator tab, indicators, blue litmus, red litmus and methyl orange and phenolphthalein. These are the indicators to find out the given substance is acid and base. In the same way, some substances are there with the help of the smell. With the help of the smell, we can find the smell. With the help of the smell, we can find the given one is acid or given one is base. Like that vanilla essence and clove oil. These are useful to find out the given substances acid and base. With the help of the smell, we are using the here solutions. With the help of the solution, we are finding the given substances acid or base. With the help of the smell, we can find out the which given substance is acid and base. Those are called the olfactory indicators. This is about the properties of the acid and bases and reaction of the acids. Next class, we will learn about the pH. the names of the some acids and bases. Already in the first activity, we are doing the activity with some acids: hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid, like that, and potassium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, like that. We can do the activity in first activity. You can write the names of that acids and bases. Children, you have to learn the names of the chemicals also. This is very important to write the chemical equations. So this is practice the write down the chemical equations for all this. You have to practice more and more. You can remember easily. Okay. The second one is already you know the activity. In the 8th class also you learn this activity. In the 8th class we are also doing the same activity. In this activity the metals acids react with and base react with metals. Which gas produce? Which gas is liberated? Hydrogen gas is liberated. In the same way, next one the third next activity the acids react with carbonates. Which gas is liberated here? Here carbon dioxide gas is liberated. You learn these two activities. You can continue. You can continue the reading, the textbook reading, and draw the diagrams. And also, we can acid solution chemicals the diagram. Draw the diagram. This is very important diagram. All of you draw this diagram. This is very important diagram. All of you draw this diagram. Here what we are going to do for the purpose of the study, we are keeping two graphite rods and the two graphite rods the HCl solution. The to find out the electricity conduct or not, for that one we are keeping here bulb. So bulb is glows here. That means the electricity conduct in the acid solutions. So bulb is glows. Electric conductivity already in the 8th class, electric conductivity lesson we will learn about this. So you have to draw this diagram. This is important, very important diagram. This is an activity, acid solution conduct electricity or not. For that one, this is one activity. So draw the diagram, all of you learn this diagram. Thank you for giving me opportunities. I will explain the next class. Thank you for watching. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.